It just kill you. Amanda and Josh think the old house they have moved into is weird, spooky, possibly haunted. And the town of Dark Falls is pretty strange as well. But their parents don't believe them. They'll get used to it, they say. Go out and make some new friends. So, Amanda and Josh do. But these new friends aren't exactly what their parents had in mind. Because they want to be friends. Forever.
Boo! Hello everyone and welcome to Cell Block Psycho's first Goosebumps review. Here we are at my old elementary school at, well, midnight, I guess. Somebody is gonna call the cops on me. Oh, shit. Right! We're gonna kick off today's episode with the very first book in the series. Welcome to Dead House. The first Goosebumps book, holy shit, this is gonna be fucking amazing, right? It's gonna be spectacular. You know, the spooks, the thrills, the chills. Well, kiddos, I have some bad news for you. It was so funny. So I was going into this book thinking it was gonna be, well, shit. But, you know, it's a kid's book. I haven't read Goosebumps, like, since I was in elementary school. I was going into this thinking it was going to be a complete boorish mess. Oh boy. Was I wrong. Welcome to Dead House still holds up. A little bit. Just a little bit. We start off our tale with Amanda Benson. A stereotypical Goosebumps character. What makes a stereotypical Goosebumps character, you ask? Well, give them a name, give them some 90s stereotypes, and no other character development whatsoever. Also introducing terrible parent number one and number two. And of course my favorite character from the book, Josh. Holy shit, he is a complete fucking friend. The whole book, he's just like, no, no. He's like 12? Four-year-olds don't act like that. I mean, okay, guys, I'm a sociopath. A little bit. But Josh has no redeeming qualities. I don't think I would give a shit if any of the characters in this book died. They're that bad, but you know what? It's a Goosebumps book. It's made for kids. That's not what we're here for. We're here for the scares. Let's get into that. So, Amanda and Josh move into a brand new house that they got from a recently deceased relative that no one in their family knows. Why look into it? No one looks into it. They just move directly into the house, like, in a week. What? Are you retarded? Okay, so you see the house, the big, beautiful Victorian house, huge rooms. It's a big upgrade. But Amanda starts seeing people around the house, people in her room, watching her. And of course, in typical Goosebumps fashion, not a soul believes her. Perfect, yeah. And there are some actual good scares in this. I mean, your home is supposed to be your sanctuary. I've actually had similar issues. When I was a kid, I had a really high imagination. I would just imagine constantly, like in the middle of the night, people in my house or imagine noises. So this one kind of hit home for me a little bit. I just wish the second half was as great as the first half, because that first half has a lot of good scares in there. So the second half of the book is where things really start to go downhill for me. Mainly because it is rushed to the shit, but it's a Goosebumps book. They're all like that. Well, it's not only rushed, I just start losing interest at that point. Because we get a good reveal about what has been going on, but we don't get enough answers, and it leaves us wanting more. Which in this case, I really did want more. And then of course, there's the ending. I gotta say, of all the endings that I remembered, this is probably my least favorite one of all of them. Because the character does something that doesn't really make too much sense to me, and it's strange how they, well, I won't spoil it. It just bothers me. Honestly, I like this story to the point where I would want to see something similar to this. Because not only the house is dangerous, but the town is even more dangerous than they would imagine. Overall, I'm going to have to give this book a 7 out of 10.
7 out of 10.
And I'm afraid I'm going to have to give it that just because of the second half. It was really just going downhill. Alright everyone, that has been my first review of Welcome to Dead House. Did you like it? Did you hate it? Do you hate me? Comment! I read all my comments. Not really. And stay tuned for next time when we cover another book. And a scary book.